It's the NFL on EA Sports.
And we've got some history in this battle of AFL alumni. We're just moments away from the action.
Coming up next.
We're a couple miles from the Colorado State Capitol building. It's Empower Field at Mile High here in Denver. Good battle coming up here in the AFC West. So glad you're with us. Mike Tirico, Greg Olson. Part of this division has been the domain of the Kansas City Chiefs. They've won 8 straight division titles, 3 Super Bowl wins during that stretch as well. And every year you get here and you ask, who can knock off the Chiefs?
Well, I think if you ask the other 3 teams in the AFC West, they would all say, okay, this is our year. But really, for a division where all 3 of those teams were sub-500 last year, now there's been some coaching changes, some new blood. But until you knock off the champ, they're still the champ. And right now, until further notice, this division continues to run through the Kansas City Chiefs. And barring something crazy, I don't expect that to change very much this year.
Here comes Amir Abdullah on the return. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Raiders offense set to take over for the first time. They'll be led out by their quarterback, drafted back in 2019 out of Washington State. It's Gardner Minshew.
Don't let this guy's laid-back personality fool you, Mike. He is a tremendous presence to have in your quarterback room. Not only does he have the ability to manage the game at a high level, but your team has a legitimate chance to beat anyone in the league whenever he's under center. Now, I don't know if I'd classify him as a long-term solution, but he's certainly someone every franchise they would love to have.
Minshew going to open up with a throw. Open man, that's Trey Tucker. And he's going to get this to the 37-yard line. Here's 1st and 10. Here's carry number 1 for the former Bulldog, Zamir White. And he's fighting to try to get back to the line of scrimmage, but will not do it. This is going to be a loss of a yard.
Great job by that linebacker timing his blitz. He didn't give any indication to the offense that he was coming. And he's able to get through that hole and take the ball carrier down for a loss.
2nd and 11. They'll go again with White. And he gets this up close to the 40. The linebacker, Cody Barton, in on the tackle. They need 8 as they come up for 3rd down. Working out of the gun, it's Minshew. And that is incomplete.
Remember what they told us, Mike, leading up to this game. They said it is so critical for us to find success, especially on 3rd down. We want to maintain possession, extend these drives. Well, the first crack comes up, and they fail through the air, and we're going to have to regroup and be able to have better success throughout the remainder of this game.
And that is good coverage by the punt team as they meet him and bring him down. The Broncos led by the rookie, quarterback Bo Nix out of Oregon. The rookie, the last of the quarterbacks taken in the 1st round, number 12 overall. He's been around, he's 24 years old, but the rookie runs it for the Broncos.
I really like this young quarterback, Mike. I think there's a lot of things that he does very well. I mean, the arm talent, it allows you to expand the playbook, his mind. He can process information both quickly and decisively. Pocket presence, impressive as well. He rarely finds himself in situations where he's a sitting duck. Now, can he put all of that together and operate an NFL offense? That's what we want to see here today. And so far, I think he's shown a lot of hope that he can grow into a future franchise quarterback.
Terrific starter there. Gain of 15 and a 1st down. They'll go play action with Nix. And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver even knew what was going on. That's incomplete. Cortland Sutton, the intended receiver, and it'll bring up second down.
As a pass rusher, you don't always need to record a sack to make your presence felt. Creating pressure, move the quarterback, affect his timing. Those are all different ways to take pressure off your coverage unit.
Got a man over the middle. There's Sutton. And they get this one across midfield to the 47-yard line.
Recognizing the blitz is just the first step in the process for a quarterback understanding who you can account for with the protection and then who you can't account for. That's where your hot receiver comes in. He points to his receiver, who the defender they're hot off of. That guy comes, gets the ball out of his hand, and results in a completion.
And some space opens as he's brought down following a gain of 6. They'll work now on 2nd and 4. On the option, here's Williams. And he'll work his way down inside the 40. Big Christian Wilkins, the one who brought him down. Now a 3rd and 2. Play action now. It's Nix. He gets this complete to Dulcich.
Offensively, landing a lot of body blows on this drive, Mike. Just the ability to steadily march the ball downfield and remain so efficient, both run and pass. As they continue to wear this defense out, they have to find a way to end this drive with points. Anything short of that would be a bit of a letdown.
A modest gain. Maybe 2 yards. It's 2nd down. From the shotgun, here's Nix. And that's going to be incomplete. Coverage was good that time. The contact jarring the ball loose and forcing 3rd down.
Really nice job there by the defense defending the middle of the field. That is the most valuable real estate on the field. They know every single offense is trying to attack the defense between the hashes. So give credit. They took away all the throwing lanes, and that ball falls incomplete.
And he does a nice job to avoid the initial wave. They're going to get him down behind the line.
In the midst of a tight game like that, you're looking for every play that you can make to try to gain advantage. And if you can continue to get after the quarterback, disrupt the rhythm and timing of this quarterback, in the second half, that could be the difference of you being able to pull away.
On 4th down, the veteran Will Lutz for the Broncos field goal. This one from 49. Lutz's kick is good. And the Broncos will take a 3-0 lead.
And I think this is going to end up being considered a successful drive, Mike. I think obviously you would have loved to see them come down and convert and score a touchdown. But at the very least, they needed to come away with 3. They were able to do that and take a lead on that field goal.
So after the field goal to open up the scoring, the kickers back out for this kickoff. Abdullah now to return. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Raiders offense ready to see the football for the 2nd time. This one has been tight so far. A field goal separating the two sides as this drive kicks off with 1st and 10. They put Adams in motion. On first and 10, it's Minshew. He's got it downfield. Myers the connection. And he's going to be brought down inside the 15.
They really showed off their connection on that pitch and catch, Mike, and just really good ball placement and really good separation downfield. And when those two things align, it's just really challenging for a defender to stay with them and take that play away.
On the move at the 14-yard line, it's first and 10. On the handoff, it's White. And nothing on that one, back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it.
You want to see linebackers play downhill, Mike, meaning there's not a lot of side-to-side pursuit. They're attacking the line of scrimmage, attacking the ball carrier. That's exactly what we saw out of this guy here. He's able to make the stop at the line of scrimmage and keep it to no gain.
Another run here with White. And he'll get back maybe to the line of scrimmage, but probably going to be a loss of a yard here.
What you see there is really the key to a good free safety blitz. Time the snap so that the offense cannot determine that you're rushing. It's exactly what happened here. He's able to bring the ball carrier down for a loss.
To the air on third down, it's Minshew. To the end zone there, but it is incomplete.
And that sideline just cannot believe their guy did not come down with that play. I mean, that's as easy as it gets. I frankly don't blame him. I mean, that's a play at this level you just have to make. Your teammates are dependent on it.
Carlson's kick is good. And the Raiders will tie the game at 3 apiece.
And that's really well done here, Mike. I mean, everything's in rhythm. A good snap, a good hold, and a good kick ties this game.
So the field goal ties things up, and we're back at it as this kicks away. Here's Smith to return it. He'll get this past the 20 before he's brought down shy of the 25-yard line. The Broncos offense about ready to get going on their second possession. They'll set out in search of a first touchdown in this game. Just a pair of field goals to show. It's 3-3 as they start first and 10. Drive begins with a run by Williams. Tough to bring down, and somehow he manages to get 4 yards out of that. Here's second and 6. Working out of the gun, it's Nix. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They got him.
The defensive coaches, they preached all week, Mike. They have to have relentless pursuit of this quarterback when he tries to extend the play. So often, it results in a great play for the offense and a big pickup. This time, because of that pursuit, it leads to a big loss.
So, backed up after the sack, and now it's third and long. To throw is Nix. Got it into the hands of Mims.
Well, let's give the defense a little credit here. You talk about read and reacting quickly. They recognize the screen right out of the jump, and he's able to beat the blocker to the spot and keep him to no gain.
And it's fourth down, so here comes Riley Dixon to punt, as he'll hit this from just outside of his own goal line. And good coverage by the punt team. They stop him before he can get any return cranked up. The Raiders offense headed back to take over once more. All even here in this opening quarter. And the drive will begin with first down. In motion is Myers. The first run for Alexander Madison. And he'll plow forward for a gain of 4 yards. Here's a second and 6. Again, it's Madison. And they'll bring him down just shy of midfield, but that is enough. It's a first down.
Second down at these distances, Mike, you pretty much anticipate a pass, and I think that's what the defense was lined up thinking. In this case, they leave a little too much room on the ground, and the offense is able to pick up a first down.
On first down, here's Minshew. And that one knocked away. It's incomplete.
So often we see when those balls get deflected up into the air, they usually turn into interceptions. I think the offense dodged a bullet here, and they're fortunate there was nobody in the area to come down with that pick.
We'll try again. It's second and 10. On the ground, this is White. And that will get him back on schedule. Good pickup of 7, sets up 3rd and 3. He'll try and throw with Minshew. And that is incomplete.
And this offense just cannot get anything going right now on third down. If you ask any offensive play caller throughout the entire league, Mike, the importance of third down, maintaining possession, making the defense stay on the field and have long extended drives, it is critical to not only scoring points, but ultimately winning in the NFL.
And that's going to work out well. Out of bounds, and they mark it inside the 5-yard line. The Broncos offense ready to come back out for this next possession. They'll start from their own 4. Not a lot of room for error back here. It's 1st and 10. They'll start this one with a 3 tight end look. A run. Here's the fullback, Burton. And that's the way you want to run it on first down. A gain of 7. Here's a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. They'll throw. It's Nix. He connects with Mims. And they're going to get him down right at the 25.
Zone route running, Mike, is very simple, right? I mean, everyone wants to complicate offensive football and make it super technical. Once you come off the line of scrimmage after the ball is snapped and you know it's zone coverage, as long as it's sort of in the area the quarterback expects you to be, my rule was just run where they're not. And when he throws it, catch it.
Nick snap on 1st and 10. That's caught on the right side by Sutton. And they'll mark him down just shy of the 40. Following the completion, we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player. So as they look at the injured player, we'll take a timeout. So, from the 39, they come up on and 10. Throwing is Nix. Fires quickly. It is complete on the slant. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield.
Great pre-snap identification by the quarterback, realizing that the blitz was coming and exactly where the soft spot in the defense would be. He's able to put that slant route right on the front shoulder pad of his receiver. Leads to a real nice run after catch and brings up first down.
On first down, here's Nix to throw. And they'll get about four here as he is taken down.
It's not the big play they were hoping for, but first down efficiency, staying ahead of the chains, is what every offense is trying to find, and it brings up a manageable second down.
Now, a second down throw for Nix. That's to the former line, Josh Reynolds. And he will get into the end zone. Josh Reynolds! Touchdown, Broncos. A terrific play all the way around. Finished off by the receiver, who not only made the grab, but Greg turned it up and takes it into the end zone.
And that's the tricky part, Mike, that transition from receiver to runner. And in this case, he does it flawlessly. Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then get upfield and get yourself in the end zone.
Will Lutz now for the PAT. The kick is good. And the Broncos take a 10-3 lead. Both teams ready to go once more as the kick's away. Abdullah now to return. He's across the 20, taken down just shy of the 25. The Vegas offense ready to get rolling again. They trail here by a touchdown as this drive will start with a first down. They'll start this on the ground, and here's White. And this is going to be a Raiders first down as the tackle's made at the 36.
This offense has to be thrilled, Mike, with the success they've had here on the ground in this opening quarter. Now as the rest of the game unfolds, everything in the game plan continues to open up.
So, from the 36, it is first and 10. From the gun, here's Minshew. That's over the middle and intercepted. Picked off by Jaquan McMillan. And his offense is going to be all set up with a short field and a chance to extend their lead.
You know, Mike, anytime a team can go nickel or dime and come off the field with an interception, I just am constantly reminded of the importance of defensive back depth when you're building an NFL roster. I mean, think back. This is not the old NFL, base 3-4, base 4-3. Offenses are going to roll out 2, 3, 4 high-level wide receivers at you in this pass-first modern era. If you can't roll out 5 DBs and all of them hold their own and be trusted to hold up, you are going to struggle defending these pass-first modern offenses.
First and 10. Here's a handoff to Williams. Trying to find some place to go, but nothing developing. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of one.
Well, they try to get the run game started here early on this drive, Mike, and they're just going to have to do a better job up front. There's really nowhere for this ball carrier to go. You never want to lose yards on first down, but that's exactly the case here.
On second down, it's Nix. In trouble, and down he goes.
Sometimes, Mike, your greatest strength can also be a little bit of your weakness. In this case, he is so used to being able to buy more time with his feet, extend the play, give his targets more time downfield to uncover. In this case, nothing materializes, tried to do too much, and as a result, takes a big loss.
Work to do following the sack. It is third and long. Throwing. Nix. He'll get that to Javonte Williams. And they were hoping for a little more on that one. Brought down well short of the first. So it'll bring up fourth down. It's Riley Dixon coming on now. He'll punt for the second time, looking to pin the opponent back deep. And no chance of a run back here. This one's going to sail out of bounds. The Raiders offense getting set to get back to work. They'll see if they can put something together here, beginning with first and 10. Drive begins with a run by White. And he's brought down after a gain of a couple. Hook him up on a second down and 8. The shotgun, a throw for Minshew. And that's going to be incomplete. Coverage was good that time. The contact jarring the ball loose and forcing third down.
I got high standards for offensive players, but in this case, Mike, I think I'm giving all the credit to the defender. He timed that one up perfectly, and what could have been an easy play ends up as an incomplete.
In motion is Myers. Play action now with Minshew. He's going to let one go, looking for Myers.
This offense is doing everything they can to quiet this crowd, and even though they missed on that long attempt, at least it sets the tone that they're going to continue to attack. They're going to continue to be aggressive, especially through the air, and if they can come up with a completion on one of those downfield passes, it's going to go a long way to settling themselves into this game.
Now, fair catch called, and he's going to take it out beyond the 25-yard line. Back onto the field comes the Denver offense. They lead by a touchdown as this drive begins with first and 10. Here's Nix to throw. Finds his tight end, Dulcich. And they'll mark him down just shy of the 40. From the 39, here's a first and 10. Now Nick's going to look to throw. This one taken in by Reynolds. And he's taken down inside the opponent's 35.
This is how you really judge quarterbacks operating in the NFL. This is not 7-on-7. This is not summer camp where the quarterback can't be touched. Everybody can throw the ball from a clean pocket. Can you operate under the fire and be on time, in rhythm, and be accurate with the ball with contact? And we saw it played out perfectly here. His ability to push the ball downfield, knowing that hit was coming, that's playing quarterback in the NFL.
One quarter in the books. It's the Broncos with the early lead. Greg and I back in Denver in just a moment. The Break the Huddle, coming up now for 1st and 10. Back to throw is Nix. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
Nice example there, Mike, of the quarterback just being smart with the ball, understanding it didn't quite develop the way he had intended. Throw that ball out of harm's way, live to play another down.
He'll try again here, 2nd and 10. They'll look to throw again. He connects. It's in the hands of Reynolds. And that'll go for a gain of 7. And it's going to set up 3rd down. From the shotgun, here's Nix.
When you're willing to throw the ball short of the sticks on 3rd down, you know what that tells me, Mike? The decision to go for it on 4th down has already been made. If you're able to pick it up with yards after the catch, great. But if not, it's a 4th and short, and you give yourself a realistic shot of converting on this 4th down.
Nix gonna throw for it. Oh, the blitz gets there. He is sacked, and they will turn it over on downs.
And here we have a real gutsy call here, Mike, early in this game offensively. I think you're giving up a surefire field goal attempt, but at the same time, you're demonstrating to your players, hey, offense, I have a lot of trust in you, and let's see if they have this same approach as the rest of this game plays on.
The Raiders offense make their way out to take over once more. They'll start it here with a 1st and 10. Three tight ends in the game to start the drive. Here's Minshew now on 1st and 10. They'll come up now for 2nd down and 4. Working out of the gun, it's Minshew. He'll go right back to Bowers. He's got it again. And he's going to be marked down up around the 33.
And you see the rookie tight end, Brock Bowers, pick up the 1st down. Mike, of all the tight ends that I've watched in college over the last, call it, 10 years or so, I'm not sure if I've seen a more dynamic, ready for the NFL tight end than Brock Bowers. I mean, 2-time Mackey Award winner, 700 plus yards each of the last 3 seasons. He can get downfield. He can make tough catches. He can run with the ball after the catch. I mean, there's not a lot this guy can't do, and I think he's got a shot to be that next big time young breakout rookie tight end.
A give, and here's White. He'll get this ahead for about 3. The linebacker, Cody Barton, in on the tackle. Here's 3rd and 7. On 3rd down, it's White. A pickup of 14 on that one. 1st down, Vegas.
Typically in a 3rd down situation like this, Mike, you're thinking pass, but give credit to this offensive play caller. He flips his tendencies upside down, keeps the ball on the ground. Not only does he get a fresh set of downs, they pick up good yardage.
Set to go now on first and 10. Now Minshew. He's got his man, Davante Adams. That is 14 for the second time. Back-to-back 14-yard gains in the first down.
So the longer that play progressed, the more difficult it is to cover that crossing route. So what's the key? It starts with pass protection. Give the quarterback time to stay with his receiver and not be forced to check that ball down.
That's a short one, caught by Bowers. After the catch, he gets that forward for a gain of 9.
The drag route. We used to say this is day one install. Every single offense in the NFL has this sort of route, especially for the tight end position. And depending on the speed and the run after catch ability of the tight end, sometimes it can lead to some of the biggest gains.
Shotgun snap and a give to White. And he'll get this inside the 20. A nice run. They're in the red zone. It's first down. On first down, right back to White. Not much there, maybe a yard. Here's second and 9. On the give, it's White. And he is not going to get away. Might have gotten a yard, but it will set up third down. To throw, Minshew. He'll try to run for it.
And that's a great job defensively here on third down. Not only taking away all the options down the field through the air, but when the quarterback decides to turn into a runner himself, they're able to converge and make the play and keep him short of the first down.
On now, Daniel Carlson to try the field goal. This a 31-yard attempt. He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Raiders cut the lead to 4. It's 10-6. Back out is Carlson following the made field goal, and he sends this kickoff away. On the return, here comes Marvin Mims. Across the 20, they'll mark him down before the 25-yard line, and that's where the offense will take over. The rookie, Bo Nix, and the Broncos offense getting set to take over once more. And he has done everything you could ask of him coming into this one. He spread it around, hasn't taken many chances, and potentially on his way to a big game throwing the football. So here's a first and 10 now. They'll start from the 24. Off the play fake, here's Nix. That is brought in downfield by Sutton. What a way to kick off a drive. That's a gain of 30 and another first down.
Those are the explosive pass plays that this team is going to continue to mine all day. And you could see pre-snap, the quarterback loved his matchup. He allowed his receiver to work downfield. Perfect throw, and now sets them up to try to see if they can finish this drive off with some points.
A fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. They'll go play action with Nix. He keeps it himself. And he'll get this forward for positive yardage as he covers up in the end.
Well, give him some credit. Initially, that looked like it was going to be a sack. He's able to escape the pressure and get away, picks up a little bit of yardage, but at least he avoids taking that shot.
Second down and 8. Working out of the gun, it's Nix. He's got it to the tight end, Dulcich.
And this is where the versatility of the tight end position really starts coming into play. Not only do they have to line up with their hand on the ground in line, but they can occasionally split out in the slot. And man, they're too fast for linebackers, and a lot of times they're too big for defensive backs.
They'll throw here on 3rd and short. That'll be caught by the running back, Williams. And this is not what they were hoping for. He is out of bounds, well short of the line to gain, and that's going to bring up 4th down.
Anytime it's 3rd and short, you better account for the running back out of the backfield, and that's exactly what they do here. Great job by the defense taking him down for a loss. Brings up 4th down.
And this one's going to land out of bounds as they'll mark it inside the 20. The visitors' offense and their running back, Zamir White, heading onto the field. They trail by 4. A touchdown gives them the lead. Drive begins with 1st and 10. Quickly, and it's Adams. And that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a 1st down completion of 7 yards.
We hear the term RPO so often, Mike, and it continues to kind of trickle its way into the NFL. But remember, it's a lot different in the NFL than it is in the college game, where it's a lot more prevalent. The lineman cannot go downfield, so that quarterback has to make a lot of really fast snapshot decisions, or else it's going to lead to a penalty or him holding on to the ball too long. So it's something that teams want to implement, but maybe not quite to the level that we see in the college game.
That's his 3rd catch of this 1st half, and good enough for a 1st down.
You can see this connection is just starting really to pick up. They're seeing the game through the same set of eyes, and that is the job of the receiver. What is my quarterback expecting from me? Where does he want me? Be there on time. And it leads to big gains like this.
On play action, here's Minshew. The pressure gets there, and down he goes. A sack.
The offense goes from feeling really good about the previous play with a real nice pickup to then on the ensuing play ending up going the complete opposite direction. Really nice job here by the defense immediately getting back on track. And what do the coaches say? Just play the next play, and that's exactly what they did.
Work to do now as they come up on 2nd and long. They'll fake the give, and now it's Minshew. A very quick throw there, but not on the same page with his target. That's incomplete.
Rough sequence over these last couple plays. 1st down sack. 2nd down big play attempt falls incomplete. Now, to make matters worse, you got to operate in 3rd and long on a defense that knows they can just pin their ears back and try to get after the quarterback.
On 3rd and long, it's Minshew. They'll set up the screen to White, and he'll be stopped short of a 1st down, and that will necessitate a call to the punt team. It's 4th down.
Just a little slow developing on that screen play there. It was pretty obvious to the entire defense exactly what was going on. Nobody was thinking pass. Nobody was getting back into their drops, and just nowhere for that back to go.
But he cannot get away. Great job down there to hold him to a short return. The Broncos offense and Bo Nix getting ready to go back to work. And he's had things all his way in the 1st half. Those numbers are sensational. He looks to add to him with another drive here. Here's 1st and 10. They'll start this on the ground. It's Williams. And he's going to have this one up near the 28.
The goal of every offense, Mike, is to find a way to establish a balance between the run and the pass. With some success here early on the ground, we'll open up things as the game unfolds for the quarterback in this passing game.
Play action now. It's Nix. Now he'll run. And he slides and covers up at the end, avoids the hit, and picked up decent yardage along the way.
Initially, Mike, a really good job by the defense. Nowhere to go with the ball for this quarterback. He's forced to pull it down and turn into a runner. Little slow reaction, and he's able to actually pick up a pretty good gain.
Now, a second down throw for Nix. Little short pass here, caught by his tight end. Now, faking the give. He finds his tight end, Dulcich. And he's close to another first down as he's brought down just shy of the marker.
Receiver just finds himself in a really nice groove, and there's these weird times in the game, Mike, where it just seems like every ball comes your way, every play they call, you're wide open, and you just find yourself in one of those grooves that athletes talk about. So they got to continue to ride the hot hand, because right now on that field, there's no mistaking who it is.
Now after the run, we get a stoppage for an injured player. And as the medical staff looks him over, we'll step aside. Here's third down and a few inches. On the bootleg, it's Nix. He'll try and get there on the ground.
This is an element that defensively you always have to be ready to defend. You can't just accept that it's a pass and be so consumed with the receivers downfield. You have to account for the quarterback as a scrambler. You can see why, as he's able to get out of the pocket and pick up the first down.
On play action, he'll set up to Oh, no chance to get rid of that one. Under a heavy rush, he goes down.
What a great job in this game by the defensive coordinator, continuing to put his players in position to succeed. And boy, have they taken advantage of it. But on the other side, they got to do something different. They got to bring in some extra blockers. They got to change up and go max protection. They have to give their quarterback a little bit of time, or else they've got no shot.
Here comes Williams on the toss to the right. It's a short pickup, taking this to the 49. Robert Spillane spills him there. Third and long. Nix from the gun on third down. This one taken in by Reynolds. And he's going to be taken down at the 30-yard line.
So far here early, Mike, the key for this offense has been their ability to maintain possession by converting on these third downs. It's going to be a big storyline the rest of the way. This defense has to find a way. When they force third down, they got to get off the field.
Mims sent in motion here. Intercepted. Picked off by Ja'Quarian Bennett. He is out of bounds, but that's a nice return. We'll give the offense the ball up past the 45-yard line. They'll come up here, first and 10. They run with White. Oh, what a run. Down inside the 30-yard line. An ideal beginning to this drive. 24 on the first play. Minshew out of the pistol here. He gets this one to Tucker. An enviable spot to operate from. Here's second and inches. The shotgun, a throw for Minshew. To the right side, hauled in by Myers.
I wouldn't be surprised if some point here in the future, Mike, this quarterback drops back. It looks like the same old hitch route underneath we've seen a few times, and they give a pump fake and go. You can lull a defense to sleep with a lot of these underneath quick game passes, and once you do, you can try to go for the big one.
Now the Raiders going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining here in half number one. So here's a chance to take the lead going into the locker room. It's first and goal. Minshew. To the end zone, but they can't connect. It's incomplete.
They went for it all on that one and just a little bit off. Ball winds up hitting the ground. They've got to move forward. The opportunities are out there. Better execution, better location, and they got some big plays in their future.
They'll try to run with White. A dive, and he's in. Zamir White. Touchdown, Las Vegas. That a big score, Greg. They continue to get points, but after not getting touchdowns, this has to feel really good to this offense.
It really does, and I think anytime you can build on your confidence that now you know the rest of this game, you can finish these good drives. Coming away with two field goals, those are wins for the defense. So now a win for the offensive side of the ball, and got to see now if you can keep this rolling throughout the rest of this game.
Carlson able to knock through the extra point, and the Raiders go up by a field goal as they lead it by three. Still a little time. Final minute of this first half. We'll see if they can do anything with this kickoff that is coming their way. And their drive will begin at the 30-yard line. The Broncos offense and receiver Cortland Sutton ready to get going again. And seemingly every time they've looked his way in the first half, it's resulted in a big play that is borne out by those eye-popping numbers. So they come to the line for first down and 10. From the shotgun, here's Nix. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of five and sets up second and five. Back to throw is Nix. Here's a screen set up to Williams. And he's going to have the first down as he gets out of bounds, and he stopped the clock as well.
We're starting to see this so often, Mike. The days of just having a running back who you're just going to turn around and hand it to, yes, that's still a critical part of NFL offensive football, but their ability to be used in the passing game, just one more thing for the defense to have to defend, make them go sideline to sideline, line of scrimmage to the end zone. Defend every blade of grass, and a really good running back goes a long way in doing that.
And it'll be taken down, but it takes them across midfield down to the 40-yard line. A first down throw for Nix. This one complete to Sutton. And he will score. Cortland Sutton. Touchdown, Denver.
This is a great example here, Mike, of an offense and a quarterback that is just in complete control and rhythm. Not only is he able to deliver this ball on target downfield, but the accuracy is what allows his receiver to stay on his feet, pick up the remaining yards after the catch, and walks it in for a touchdown.
Here's Lutz now for the extra point. He's got it. And the Broncos make the lead four. It is 17-13. Halftime, coming close, and not much time left as this one is kicked away. This one will be taken in the end zone. No run back forthcoming, and the ball coming out to the 30-yard line. They're just going to run it here up the middle. Nice job finding the seam. Gain of about nine. Just a yard short of that first down. Second and a yard. From the gun, here's Minshew. He'll be hit as he throws this time, and it's going to fall incomplete. He might be fortunate just to avoid the sack, and it'll set up a third down.
They got there in a hurry, didn't they, Mike? I mean, luckily for him, he saw that free rusher coming, and at the very least was able to get that ball out to prevent the sack.
Going to wind up incomplete. Not much time remaining. Time for one more snap here in this first half.
There's a saying on defense, Mike, tips and overthrows, you've got to get those. Those got to turn into interceptions. So if you're the offense here, after you saw that ball batted in the air, man, I can promise you it felt like a lifetime waiting to see if it just falls harmlessly to the ground.
And the rush is going to get there. He'll go down. They were taking a big risk, going for it in their own territory. It will not pay off. It's a turnover on downs.
It's always a gamble anytime you go for fourth down on your side of the field, but they clearly thought they had a play that they liked, but the defense came up huge, and now their offense is going to have a chance to capitalize and take advantage of this short field.
On now, it's Will Lutz to try the field goal. This one from 47 yards out. He is 2 for 2. That kick is good. And the Broncos going to tack on 3 more, extending the lead here late in the first half.
Okay, Mike, thank you. More from you and Greg in a moment. But for now, welcome one and all to our EA Sports Halftime Report. It was a terrific first half for the rookie first-round pick, Bo Nix. He's over 300 yards passing already as he's looking to possibly put his name in the record book.
Coach, thank you. Both teams trying to find the right formula to come out on top in this second half coming up. Pretty interesting first half. We'll see if any strategy changes for the next 30 minutes or more as this second half gets underway. And that's well done by the kicking team. He's only able to make it past the 15-yard line. The home team's offense and their quarterback set to take the field once more. And as we take you through some of the highlights so far, you're going to see a lot of passing yards. He has carved up this defense, over 300 yards passing in the game, and has been sharp right from the start. Drive begins with a run by Williams. He'll work his way ahead for a gain of about 4. Here's a 2nd and 6. Throwing. Nix. He's hit as he threw. It goes to the ground, and it's an incomplete pass. Third and 6. Now Nick's going to look to throw. To the outside, hauled in by Sutton.
The initial reaction is, how does this quarterback not throw the ball past the first down line to gain to try to extend this drive? And the reality is, because they've already decided they're going to go for it on fourth down. If he doesn't pick up the extra yards after the catch, they've got a fourth down play call they feel great about, and we're going to see what it looks like.
Now a fair catch, and it's going to be a long field. They'll take over right about their own 13. The visitors' offense and their running back getting set for this next possession. And you have to imagine the defense is saying, how do we stop this guy? He has run roughshod through him to this point in the third quarter. They put Adams in motion. They'll start on the ground, and here's Madison. And this rough day on the ground continues. They're going to drop him behind the line again.
Every team makes an emphasis on winning first down, but as a defense, when you're able to take them back for a loss, Second and long, you can really become more of a pass-centric defense and really tips the scales into your favor.
On the ground, it's White. White, first down and much more. And he's going to be out of bounds. They mark him up near the 35-yard line. They get 21 on that one. First down, Vegas.
It's definitely nice to have one of those bruising, punishing backs to kind of help wear down the defense. And I'll tell you what, you can give me a flat-out electric runner like this guy any day of the week. He can turn on those jets, get in that high gear, and he is gone.
They'll go again with White. And he finds a little bit of space. He'll take this forward for a gain of 4. Here's 2nd and 6. He's got Myers on the completion. And they'll whistle him down, but not before he picks up a first down after a gain of 7. Working out of the gun, it's Minshew. To the outside, it's brought in by Adams.
Nice job here by the defense. Did a good job just covering up everything for the most part. So once this ball was caught, really didn't have much of a choice but to just head out of bounds and pick up a modest gain.
Throwing is Minshew. The ball deflected at least a couple of times, but it'll fall to the ground. It's incomplete.
He may have trusted his arm strength a little bit too much on that throw. Two defenders in the area. Work to your check down. Work to an open receiver. I think in this case, he forces that ball, and ultimately, he's lucky he got away with it.
That's into the hands of Tucker. He's got it. And he's going to have the first down. So they convert on third down with a pickup of 9. Caught by Tucker. And that keeps him ahead of schedule. That's a first down completion of 7 yards. Here's a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. They'll run here with Madison. And the struggles in the running game continue. They take him down behind the line.
You have to wonder if next time, does the play caller give his quarterback some options to check out of this play? It was clear before the ball was snapped. This was not a great look for that play call, and you can see the end result.
Here's a 3rd down and 4. He'll try and throw with Minshew. He'll look middle, and he's got his man complete.
And this is the blueprint, Mike. The ability to sustain and maintain possession and methodically move the ball down the field in the process. They've been in complete control. They've been able to dictate what they want to do offensively and make the defense react. The defense has had no answers up until this point. And now the next step is, can they come away with 6? Because anything less than that, after this long drive, would be a...
Nowhere to get away, and he's going to go down.
If there's any silver lining for this drive, Mike, it's the fact that at least this sack occurred on an early down. So I guess technically they have a chance to claw themselves out of this hole, but that's the 3rd sack of the game. And this defense doesn't show any signs of slowing down.
We're going to go play action now with Minshew. He's got the tight end, Mayer. Third and long. Here's Minshew. Oh, that's the one thing they couldn't have there, the sack that might take them out of field goal range.
Quarterback just has to get this ball out of his hands. I understand giving your guy a chance to pick up the first down. Let's see if he can get some space downfield past the sticks and put one on him. But once it's clear that's not going to work, this ball either needs to be thrown away, checked down, but you certainly don't want to continue to go backwards.
The Raiders send their punt team out as they'll say no to the long field goal and hope to pin them deep. And no return forthcoming. It's a touchback and will come out to the 20-yard line. The home team's offense and their quarterback headed out for their next possession. And he's had it going in the first half. Really had his way with the secondary. They have been powerless to stop him. Now, they're going to try to keep it going. The drive begins at the 20. Here's first and 10. They run over center with Williams. And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more.
These edge rushers, they are judged by their sack totals, Mike. They love to rush the passer. But they have responsibilities in the run game as well. Great job here, keeping it to no gain.
They'll try again. It's second and 10. They'll go again with Williams. And that's good run support on the edge. Nice tackle out wide. That'll hold them to a gain of 2. Got to get it to the 30. Here comes third down. Working out of the gun, it's Nix. And on third down, that ball incomplete.
So the hope is your one third down conversion from really jump-starting a possession that ultimately leads in points. But after that third down incompletion, kind of throws a wrench into those plans.
The Broncos bringing out their punter, as he's on for the fifth time this afternoon. Fair catch is called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. The Raiders' offense back onto the field for their next possession. And look, they've been out of sorts throughout, Greg. They haven't had any answer for this pass rush all game.
Yeah, and it's really showing up in the sacks and also just in their ability to prevent any yards, any completions. This has just been a dominant pass defense performance here, and everything starts with the rush. The quarterback's uncomfortable. The clock gets sped up. He's got guys in his face. It's a lot easier to play defensive back and in some of these coverage units when you know that ball's got to come out fast, and right now they're teeing off and taking advantage of it.
Quick throw taken in. That's a nice pickup on a first down throw. It's a gain of 8.
Similar to a tight end, the slot receiver is often considered the safety blanket. He makes all the difficult catches, tends to be a little bit more around the line of scrimmage, and so far today, he's certainly lived up to that reputation.
Here's second and 2. Now it's White. And he'll bring this up to the 48-yard line. And that's a first down. Now Minshew to the left side, and Adams has it. a give, and here's White. He'll struggle to get back to the line of scrimmage. Maybe gets a yard out of that one. It's second down. Here comes White on the toss right. It'll take this ahead for a gain of about five, and here comes third down. To throw, Minshew. He's going to be brought down very close to that line to gain. They're going to mark him just a bit short. And now it's fourth down.
You can see here, Mike, the impact that sending your receivers deep does to the defense. You add so many layers, and the defense has to get so much depth in their pass coverage. It leaves a lot of room underneath, and that's exactly what the quarterback takes advantage, tucks the ball down, turns into a runner, picks up the first down.
Back is Minshew. That is incomplete. They took a chance throwing it on fourth and short, but not to be, and they'll turn it over on downs.
And the running back just has nowhere to go. There is no crease. There is no seam. You got to give credit. That defensive line overwhelmed the offensive line, and that went a long way to forcing that fourth down stop.
First and 10. Dulcich now brought in motion. On the give, it's Williams. The hole closes quickly. He'll pick up about three. Second and 7. To throw is Nix. That's caught on the right side by Sutton. He'll get about six before he's taken down.
So they have these rules for the receivers, Mike. They call them green grass rules. And the idea is if you're running across the field and you're looking at the quarterback, you're going to stay on the run. If you're not looking at the quarterback, that tells him, I'm going to sit in this soft zone. I'm going to what they call punch and pivot and stop. And that tells the quarterback to put the ball on your chest. That nonverbal communication between the receiver and the quarterback, recognizing when you're open, stay open, that's the stuff that makes a lot of these offenses so difficult to defend. Nothing real fancy about this call here, Mike, right? In this third and short, just get the ball to your running back. Make sure he has enough space to pick up the first down, and they're able to convert.
A gain of four as he's taken down. Now, a second down throw for Nix. This one taken in by Reynolds. And it'll be a short pickup that's not enough for the first down. Third and a yard. He'll try to run for it with Williams. First and 10 now from the 36. They'll throw. It's Nix. Who else? Another catch for his favorite target. He'll come to the line now on second and two. From the shotgun, here's Nix. Now he'll run it.
I love this call, Mike. Second down and short. One of the best downs in football to take a shot. Give credit to the defense. They were ready for it. But a nice job by the quarterback, realizing there's nothing downfield. Take off, turn into a runner, pick up the first down.
On first down, here's Nix to throw. There's that man again. Another catch.
Well, let's give some credit to the big boys up front in the trenches. They knew that blitz was coming. They held up just long enough that the quarterback could get that ball out safely and results in a completion.
Second down and three. Here's the give up the middle with Williams. And the Broncos are going to have a first and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points. They'll send a tight end in motion. They'll run. It's Williams. He'll be wrapped up there down at the 3-yard line. Now, here's second and goal. On the bootleg, it's Nix. And he won't quite get in. Down to the one, setting up third and goal.
Coming into the game, this is something defensively you have to be aware of. If this quarterback gets a chance and he sees some daylight, he's going to try to take it in on his own. But not in this case. They were quick to react, stop him short. Now brings up third and goal.
They'll try to run it with Williams. Powering forward. He's in. Javonte Williams, touchdown Broncos. So on third and goal, they run it in. Sometimes, Greg, that's four down territory. They didn't need to do it on fourth down, taking care of it on the third down for the touchdown.
Yeah, and when you find yourself down here this close, Mike, you have to finish these drives off. I'm with you. I think he was going to give his back two shots there to punch it in, but he only needed one.
Lutz for the extra point. It's up and through. And the Broncos will extend this third quarter lead. The kickoff team is out on the field. And we're back to it as the kick's away. This one taken at the 7. He'll get this up to the 28-yard line. Nice place for the drive to start. The visitors' offense and their running back getting ready to go back to work. And as you take a look at the numbers, you have to imagine he was the topic of conversation in that locker room at halftime. They got to find a way to slow him down. Nothing they've done has worked so far. They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. Drive begins with a run by White. And this will be a short pickup to about the 30. DJ Jones, the big defensive tackle, with the stop. Hook him up on a second down and 8. Another run here with White. He'll manage only about 3, so it will bring up 3rd down. So, 3 quarters now in the books. Back with more after the break. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. Third and 5. From the gun, here's Minshew. He's got a man. That's Myers. 11 yards on the pass there. Good for a Raider first down.
Okay, so now you pick up that first down, Mike, but now there needs to be a sense of urgency. You know you need to score twice. So this one, ideally for the offense, results in a touchdown. But either way, this first score of the two needed needs to be fast because you need every possession you can here late in the fourth quarter.
Throw over the middle, brought in by Adams. And they're going to work this down inside the 45.
Things certainly look a little improbable right now, Mike, but I wouldn't say impossible. I think they've got to capitalize on this possession to pick up some points. Good start there. Early completion, but now they've got to get across midfield and go. Every single possession right now is priceless. Points, possessions, and then they got to get some defensive stops.
Looking middle, and he's got Myers. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line.
The key to good route running, Mike, is deceiving the man covering you into thinking you're doing one thing, and then you change it and do the other. And in this case, he had the defender thinking this was a vertical downfield route, and then next thing you know, he gets to his break point, he breaks in, and that ball's put right on the money for a big pickup.
He's got room to roam. And he's very close to a touchdown. They mark him just shy of the goal line.
And this is what the offense needed. Now, after that last completion, you still trail here in the fourth quarter. You need scores, and you need scores fast, so they cannot take their time. I wouldn't be surprised to get them right back up on the line of scrimmage and try to score here now that it's first and goal.
Well, a chance to get right back in it here. First down and goal. They'll run with White. And he will score. Game on. Zamir White, touchdown Vegas. That is second touchdown of the afternoon. Greg, they are pecking away at this one now. Very big touchdown. Gets them right within reach of pulling this comeback off.
Well, Mike, at the very least, they've given themselves a chance. But can they get a stop and get the ball back again for a chance to go down and really make this one interesting?
So, things a little more interesting now. Back to a one-score game as they kick it away. On the return, here's Mims. And that's well done by the kicking team. He's only able to make it past the 15-yard line. The Broncos offense and their wide receiver getting ready to get back to work. And he's looking to finish strong. He has been unquestionably the star of the show, as they have just absolutely had no answer on the defensive side of the ball. A a fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Here's Nix to throw. He connects with Mims. And they bring him down, but not until he gets the 45-yard line. Mims sent in motion here. Here comes the jet sweep. And he'll be out of bounds, but not before he gets inside the 35-yard line. Wow, they are moving the ball to start this drive. 21 on that play. Nix, now to throw it here on first down. That's over the middle, but it's incomplete.
Timing and trust. Critical elements of this quick passing game. If your target and the quarterback are not on the same page, it winds up being an incompletion and a wasted down.
They'll try again here. Second and 10. Here's a handoff to Williams. Maybe a couple there. It's third down. Nix from the gun on third down. And that is incomplete.
I think he predetermined that third down throw, and even though the coverage was tight, he still tried to fit the ball in there anyway, and it ended up falling incomplete. I think if he goes through his progressions and has a little bit more trust in his protection, I think there's an easier throw to make out there.
And this one, right down the middle. It's good. And that could be big. They now take a 2-score advantage. Both teams ready to go once more. As the kick's away. Now return coming from the 7. And he'll be brought down right around the 25-yard line. The Raiders offense headed back to take over once more. The deficit is at 10, so an important drive forthcoming. Getting started with 1st and 10. They put Adams in motion. Here's Minshew now on 1st and 10. And he got rid of that one quickly before the receiver even knew what was going on. That's incomplete.
Can't exactly put my finger on it, but it just seems like this entire game, like this passing game and this quarterback specifically, they've just been off. And whether it's missing these big shots downfield like he did there or just simple underneath layups, there's just something about him today that doesn't look right, and I think it's a big part of the reason they find themselves trailing here in the fourth quarter.
This offensive line just has no answers right now. It's another sack.
So after picking up some positive yardage on first down, they end up going backwards on second. That sack now brings up third and long, and but most of the time is a very pass-happy situation, makes them very one-dimensional.
Work to do following the sack. It is third and long. Working out of the gun, it's Minshew. And that is incomplete.
This is teach tape for man defense, Mike. I mean, he is not looking back at the quarterback at all. He is in the hip pocket of his receiver. He's staying in phase and in rhythm. And then he knows when the wide receiver's hands go up, attack the ball, and that's about as good as it gets.
And no return on this one. Fair catch signaled for and taken. The Broncos offense and the wideout getting set to go once more. And he's had some kind of game. They made it a point to get him involved early. Boy, did that pay great dividends to this point. So they come to the line for first down and 10. Throwing is Nix. Got it into the hands of Mims. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield.
Anytime you're playing zone defense and everybody's eyes are on the quarterback, it's really easy to lose sight of some of the receivers. That's exactly what happened here. He started all the way on the far side of the field and worked his way across, found a soft spot in the zone, and quarterback's able to put it on him.
On the option, here's Williams. And they bring him down, but not until they get inside the 30-yard line.
Two-possession lead, fourth quarter. This is the time, Mike, when you really can rely heavily on your run game. Everybody in the stadium knows you're going to run it, including the defense. They just can't come up with an answer to stopping it.
They'll go play action with Nix. Off-balance throw. It's complete. The first-round pick looking right at home in this offense. It's a first down.
A little surprising here, Mike. They continue to throw the ball with this type of lead here in the fourth quarter, but with the day they've had and the upper hand they've had against this pass defense, I don't know if I could really blame them. I mean, with the amount of man coverage that they're seeing, right now, the quarterback's just saying, what's my best matchup? Who do I love to gain separation? And just throw them the ball, and for the most part of the game, it's continued to work.
They'll work now on second and four. Now Nick's going to look to throw. He's going to lose yardage here, taken down back at the 8-yard line.
To play corner in this league, Mike, you have to have great reactions and instincts. In this case, he trusts those instincts from the jump. And he's able to send the offense going backwards as a result.
This defense in desperate need of a stop, and here comes third down. Working out of the gun, it's Nix. And the rush gets there. He'll be tracked down.
And the big guys up front in the offensive line just continue to not be on the same page. And we've seen it time and time again here today. This pass rush remains one step ahead of him, and it's the quarterback who continues to pay the price.
On now, it's Will Lutz to try the field goal. This, from extra point range, a 33-yard field goal attempt. Another one through the uprights. He's 4-for-4 on the game. And the Broncos add on to their lead. The kickoff team is out on the field, and we're back to it as the kick's away. This taken at the 5. and he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Raiders offense and Jacoby Myers set for their next drive. The deficit is double digits, so work to do as they begin this drive with first and 10. They'll stick to the ground. And he'll get two on this one before being taken down. Second down and 8. The shotgun, a throw for Minshew. And he's going to go down yet again. He has been under fire all game long.
So after surrendering their 6th sack of the game, I looked down on the sideline, Mike, and found their offensive line coach. He grabbed his headset, removed it, and he slammed it on the ground. And truthfully, I don't blame him. His unit has been getting worked up front all day in pass protection.
So backed up after the sack, and now it's 3rd and long. Throwing is Minshew. This offensive line just has no answers right now. It's another sack.
This has been a masterful game plan defensively. I mean, not only have they found their mismatches and been able to exploit them, it's led to 7 sacks so far. I mean, even when the offense seems to make an adjustment, Mike, the defense just still seems to be one step ahead of them.
Trailing late, they've got to go here. It's 4th down. Here's Minshew. He gets this complete, finding Adams. And he will take this one in. 84 yards. Touchdown, Vegas.
Well, it seems this game is kind of getting to the point, Mike, where it's defense optional. I mean, both these teams are really just having their way with their opponent. They're going up and down the field. And after this long touchdown, yes, this is great if you're a fantasy player, but it's not so great if you're a defensive coordinator.
Carlson now for the extra point. He's got it. And the Raiders are back within 6. So, things a little more interesting now. Back to a 1-score game as they kick it away. On the return, here's Mims. And that's well done by the kicking team. He's only able to make it past the 15-yard line. The home team's offense and their quarterback ready to go once more. And this defense might be about ready to wave the white flag. Nothing they have tried to throw at him has been successful. He just processes things so quickly, making the right read, seemingly every time. Set to go now on 1st and 10. Dulcich now brought in motion. The drive begins with a run by Williams. Javonte Williams! Inside the 20! And he's into the end zone. That might be the knockout punch. Javonte Williams. Touchdown, Denver. 2 touchdowns for him now in the afternoon. Everything you want to do right there, Greg, in the fourth quarter, get the ball with the lead and extend it to a two-score advantage.
Yeah, and I think this just might end up being too much to overcome. You said it. Once you get a two-score lead this late in the fourth quarter, there's just not enough possessions to be had to claw yourself back in it.
And now, after the big play, gotta cut that celebration short, because they're gonna stay out and go for two. Back to throw is Nix. Ah, the pressure, too much, and he goes down.
I'm always curious how a defense is going to respond. So you give up a touchdown, you give up six, and now the offense is trying to extend it to eight. How are you gonna buckle down? How are you gonna hang in there? In this case, let's give them a little credit. Keep those two off the board, and they can come to the sideline and regroup.
Both teams ready to go once more. As the kick's away. Abdullah now to return. The Raiders offense and their running back set to go once more. They'll see if they can put something together here, beginning with first and 10. On play action, here's Minshew. And a good effort there defensively. It's knocked away and incomplete. Trying to get it to his tight end, Brock Bowers. It's second down.
Just a great example of not only the anticipation, but the instincts to go break that pass up. Mike, you can see he's clearly looking at the quarterback's eyes. And once that ball was delivered, he's just attacking it and breaking it up.
Very quick throw there, but not on the same page with his target. That's incomplete.
They're lucky to have avoided this mistake here, Mike. In the fourth quarter, with possessions running out, that would have been a critical backbreaking play in this game. And they're going to have second life now after that defender drops the ball. And let's see if they can take advantage of it.
To the air on third down, it's Minshew. And that is incomplete.
Just didn't quite get enough into that ball. You see sometimes the pressure, the rush, force a quarterback to throw the ball off his back foot. And I think there was a little bit of that here at play. You have to be willing to step up, even in the face of pressure, and get enough behind that ball to put that one a little bit more on the money.
Now or never, they'll throw on fourth down. That's over the middle and take it in. He's got it. And he's going to have a Raiders first down. As this defense a little too loose there, giving up 19 yards on fourth down.
Some teams just have a stronger appetite for being willing to go for fourth down tries, even on their side of the field, Mike, and we're seeing it so much more often. The days of just punting the ball back and forth and saying, hey, we're going to play good defense. Remember, the better your defense, that doesn't mean you should punt. The better your defense, the more chances you should take on offense.
He's got it downfield. Myers the connection. And he's going to be taken down at the 30-yard line.
Desperation time now setting here in the fourth quarter. This is where the urgency of your two-minute offense is so critical. How many plays can you run and how fast can you run them? Because one score is not going to do it. You're going to have to score and get the ball back and end up going down and punching it in again.
Now he'll run, and he'll gain yardage and able to get down at the end of the play.
That play had sack written all over it, so that's a great job by the quarterback, not only escaping the initial pressure, even though he doesn't gain a whole lot, he's able to pick up some positive yards for what looked like a disaster in the start.
Now Minshew. That's a short one, caught by Bowers. And that's going to be a first down, a pickup of 9. Out quickly, and it's Adams. And the Raiders are going to have a first and goal. Very nearly a touchdown. He's going to be marked out of bounds just shy of the pylon. 2 receptions for him on this drive. This one, good for 16 yards.
I love the way the ball's been moving around to different guys this drive, Mike. I mean, it really keeps the defense guessing and off balance. And now, this defense is going to have to figure out how to keep this offense out of the end zone because it's first and goal.
From the 1 yard line, first down and goal. He'll try to run with White, and he's into the end zone yet again. Zamir White, touchdown Las Vegas. That is his 3rd touchdown of the afternoon. Good drive. They kept the ball. Greg, they moved it effectively down the field and finish it off on the ground for the touchdown.
So often, Mike, we see teams work on a great drive to get down here close only to settle for a field goal. But in this case, give them a lot of credit. They put a great drive together, but they're able to capitalize and finish it off with 6.
Carlson's kick is good. And the Raiders have cut the deficit to 5. So, things a little more interesting now. Back to a 1-score game as they kick it away. Here's Smith to return it. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. Javonte Williams heading out with the Broncos for their next drive. And as we look at the highlights, you see it's been tough to stop him here today. Couple of touchdowns in this ball game. He has, without a doubt, been the driving force in this offense so far. Here's 1st and 10. They'll start this on the ground. It's Williams. And he's going to be stopped in his tracks. He'll lose a couple of yards on that one.
At this stage in the 4th quarter, great job by the defense, understanding exactly what the offense is trying to do. They're trying to bleed the clock, shorten the game. They completely sold out to stop the run, able to take him down for a loss.
They'll go again with Williams. Williams, 1st down, and he's not done. They'll mark him down up at the 44-yard line.
4-minute offense, Mike, so what does it mean? 1, make the defense use all of their remaining timeouts. 2, continue to pick up first downs, milk the clock. And then 3, if possible, finish with the ball in your hands.
On 1st down, right back to Williams. Not much to speak of on that one. Maybe a gain of a yard. It's 2nd down. Williams gets it on the draw. And he'll be taken down as the clock ticks towards 2 minutes to play. creates another run here for Williams. Well, they weren't going to get him the second time with the same back. Defense all over that one. They stop him for no gain. They'll try again. It's second and 10. On the give, it's Williams. He'll get about three, and that's going to lead to third down. Whistles here. We have another stoppage. Timeout called by the defense with 1:53 remaining. What can they do here on third down and 7? They'll drop to throw. That'll be caught by the running back, Williams. And he's very close to a first down, but it doesn't look like he got there. And yes, they're going to mark him a yard short. They only need a yard. And it's fourth down. Reynolds is the motion man here. They'll go for it. It's Williams. And he is going to have the Broncos' first down. They only needed one, but it's a gain of 6, and it'll move the chains.
Little test of wills up front, huh, Mike? I mean, who wanted this one more? Who would get off the line quicker? Who would drive the other side backwards? Pretty impressive that not only are they the ones that won the battle, the defense knew what was coming and still couldn't stop it.
The defense still with all three timeouts at their disposal as the quarterback's down 2 and E. So mile-high salutes all around. It's a win for the Broncos. This was a game where both offenses were up and down the field, marching the ball at will, matching each other point for point. But in the end, they got a few more defensive stops than their opponents did. And that was the difference in this one.